Silence is in the station. human vision. We call them next election. And the debts that they move to IMF organization leave us in desolation. And I see worries and problems. Get the youth are still holding on strong. Do they seek to the right, not the wrong? Not the wrong. I love how them go along. Worries and problems. Get the youth are still getting a fight.
Clear face the right. Of King Yahushua. So what about now? So make sure and share this live.
Give me faith, oh Jah, I pray, oh Lord, to face another day.
So I have a lot to show you today, and one of the things that I'm going to show you is the dome. I'm going to be showing you the dome today. Yes, the glass dome. We're going to be seeing a full live video of the dome today. Elohim has shown us real love, real patience for far too long now, right? So we want to give Elohim the love and everything from our hearts with this song.
Someone to cut me loose.
One more last time. Stones manifest multicolored dimensional stone of the new Yerushalayim, the new Jerusalem as you know it.
Trouble water, you're still at these tiny. what is seen, the natural eye. A great event is being prepared. A war and a wedding feast will have their place in time. Soon and not yet is the word that the watchman gives as he strains his eyes through the darkness of the night mist. He can sense that just beyond the horizon, a great brightness is preparing to break forth. Arise, you sleepers! Shake off your slumber, he calls. Come and fill your lamp with fresh oil. Trim your wick. Cry out in the streets and do not let your voice be silent. For the coming of the great king is at hand. Arise and shine, for your light has come. And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Only wait for the Lord. Be strong and of a good courage. And wait for the Lord. A watchman on your walls, O Jerusalem. They will not be silent day or night of the Lord. They make constant mention. They will give no sleep to their eyes until God establishes grace. There will be no peace in the nights until the Lord makes Jerusalem a praise. Jesus won it by his strength.
If you lift up your voices and call on the Lord, he will come. And the nations will see that salvation comes from Zion.
Oh, no more waiting, the anointing of God has begun.
Oh, blinders will see as the captives go free. If you lift up your voices,
are you ready for it? Are you ready? Are you ready?
Behold, the Lord has proclaimed to the ends of the earth. And though there's fear in your streets tonight, something's already birthed. Tabernacle is rising right now in the hearts of those who believe. There's the sound of a freedom shout rising up from under your feet.
If we lift up our voices and call on the Lord, he will come. And the nations will see that salvation comes from Zion.
I have never seen this nowhere on YouTube, Twitter, nowhere. I've never seen this moment of glory in my entire life. Nowhere on YouTube, nowhere on Twitter. So this will be an opportunity to share this live. Are you ready to pick it up? Are you ready for the rapture? Are you ready for the catching our way? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for the rapture? Are you ready for the catching our way? Are you ready? Are you ready? These are the days, yeah! Look at glory.
The days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial,
so these are the days
of famine and darkness.
So we are on the final chapter now. We're on the last verse of Revelation.
Still we are the voice in the dead.
And partly through Exodus. So today, I'm going to be teaching you, if we have time, again, about Yellowstone. I'm going to teach you about the sinkholes, the offerings. I'm going to be teaching you about the earthquakes. Hey, what's up to you, Rachel? And I'm going to be teaching you about the pole reversal shift. So there's a life that I need to be all about now. Forget every other life that doesn't contain Elohim's holiness. So nobody on the earth can tell what is causing the cracks but me, because these things I have foretold you all months, even years ago, what will happen in 2018. I've said it, people laugh at me, people mock, and all sorts of other evil things. Now it's happening. Truly ready for this polar reversal shift. The east will be where the west is, the west will be where the north is, the north will be where the east is, the west will be where the south is. It will be a total confusion when those poles switch. And are you also ready for the 5G technology, which is going to fry your brains, and it's also going to destroy your red blood cells as well as a white blood cell?
Glory in your embrace. all see that? Oh my God, one of the foundation stones of the New Jerusalem. Whoa! Hallelujah! Glory be to Elohim! Whoa! Wow! Hallelujah! One of the foundation stones of the New Jerusalem, brothers and sisters.
One of the foundation stones of the New Jerusalem. Wow! Awesome, isn't it? Whoa!
It's very huge. You can't see it with your plain eyes, but it's huge. What the heck? It reflecting on the glass. Look at the reflection now. That is the reflection, and this is real. See, it doesn't move in the sun. This is real. So, brothers and sisters, this is the foundation stone of the New Jerusalem. Make sure and share this life. We're going to put on some more worship and we're going to get some more colors. More colors going to manifest us now.
Back. Well, it's too late.
But there's a conflict in the round. No, something to honor.
Hey, what's up to the army in the Philippines?
Revolution, why start?
Hey, what's up to every brother, every sister? Pick up yourself now.
Let your feet up. Ain't stop walking your sleep. Lift your hands up. It's no time.
So there's a lot of conflicts in their heart right about now. Because they choose unrighteousness rather than choose righteousness.
To take the fear. Let them say, hey, say what they wanna say. Did they hear the people cry? I feel the pain we bear. You betrayed us and you say.
So now what do? They betrayed Elohim and they betrayed us who in the army of Elohim. No, they cannot be trusted at all.
Say that.
So they were given one final opportunity to repent and come back. And they take that as a granted.
You care, you are convinced us with your lies. So please know the answer. Wake up.
So wake up, people of the earth. It's time to wake up. And don't lose your true enemies.
It's a broken your sleep. Lift your hands up. It's no time to take the fear. If we never need no government, we shall surely push it over. Only to be left. Them no fascinate with, them can't fascinate with. We got the right to choose our own destiny. Jaja a defend with, and them not be friend with. Cause we don't come to lose, but the poverty will do it to it. Our children, we come
away.
Thank you.
nowhere to run. And I love to see that. But the words of Yahuwah is coming to pass rapidly. So sadness that I creep on their face, and I will have a big smile on my face because I know that day has come.
And the people them chase, smile on my face, that day will come when I just stand and see all those wicked men and the fire getting burned. That day will come when they will try to escape and there will be nowhere to run. That day will come when I shall see their hand in all the bombs.
So that day has come, brothers and sisters. So when they find out, when they find out that they can't escape, that day will come when they find out that people are only trying to help them escape their own enemies, who was enslaving them all the time through religion, through traditions, through different things, different feasts in the earth. And people trying to rescue them from their own peril.
That mistake send on the people them trace, smile on my face, that day will come when I just stand and see.
So that day has come, brothers and sisters. I'm telling you this, that day has come.
You're those wicked men, and the fire getting burned.
So all wicked man, if there's a wicked man, whether he's a Christian, whether he's a Hebrew, whatever religion you are in, if you are serving an idol, a deity, anything that is not the creators themselves, Elohim, or anyone that is not the creator Elohim themselves, then you're in trouble. And that includes Jesus, Lucifer, Christ.
They will come when they will try to escape and they will be nowhere to run. That they will come when I shall see their hand in all the bombs and bring it and put it and gun. That they will come when in Parasolas will actualize the one they get to do them out of this long. Who do you think?
So people need to wake up. Really, really wake up now. Really wake up now.
We're living in this world.
And don't try to persecute us for trying to help you escape. Because that's what we're trying to do. We try to help you escape the destruction of Yahuwah that is coming. So the world that we live in is a small world. Indeed.
As slick as you think you are, we're living in a small world.
So we try to help the only Christians escape. But you know what? They don't need to be saved. They're saying that. They don't want to be saved. Listen, Christians, all religious people, you get enough time. Enough time you got.
As tough as you think you are.
So therefore you have no excuse whatsoever. All the worshiping all kind of idols. I want to enter the new Jerusalem. It don't work so. You were given an opportunity to repent and return in righteousness. But you refuse that and you reject Yahushua. So the thing that they're going to escape, the evil Christians on them, the thing that they're going to escape, you know what I mean? They think they're going to escape, but fire not burn them, you know? If you don't repent and truly walk in holiness, in obedience, in righteousness, and be humble before the Creator's Elohim, then, only then, if you start to walk upright before the Most High Yah, then you'll be reconsidered and given an opportunity to enter into the ark.
Make sure you don't let no life in a sorrow. Make sure you're not lead them straight like arrow. Make sure you...
So it's time to wake up, people. It's really time to wake up.
Don't no push out in a barrow. Make sure you make them walk out and barrow. Yeah, make sure your meditation are narrow. Judgment, the wrong time from the world I want. That day will come when I shall stand and see all the wicked men in the fire getting burned. That day will come when they will try to escape and they will be nowhere to run. That day will come when I shall see them hanging over bombs and bayonets and bullets and guns. That day will come when the Apostle shall rise up on the wings of the...
When you're speaking the truth to human beings, they doesn't want that to know. And then they will say, Diana, we never hear no truth. What we learned, we thought was the truth. But the Most High will say, yeah, we sent messengers along the way to help you to catch yourself back, to come back. But you reject them, you stone them, you spit on them, you persecute them, you do all sorts of evil things to them. But now, I ain't sending back no messenger at all. You're defending your own now.
I will remain the same, hailing Rastafari name. And what
watch them going up in flames. For all the innocent going down the drain. You have to
be told them, escape today, you can't escape tomorrow. Make sure you stay back anytime you borrow. Make sure you don't let no life in a sorrow. Make sure you're not lead down straight like arrow. Make sure your brains not push out in a barrow. Make sure you make them walk out and borrow. Yeah, make sure your meditation and arrow. Judgment, everyone tell him something the other one. That day will come when I say tendency on those wicked men. In a fire getting burned. That day will come when they will try to escape and they will be nowhere to run. That day will come when I shall see they handing over guns and bayonets and bullets and guns. That day will come when Emperor Selassie and shall rise up on the wings of the heavens and the sun. Oh, yes, I will remain the same.
God, give me strength to face another day.
So people say in our groups that nothing that I speak comes to pass, but I have no idea that it's actually taking place, but they are brainwashed. So right about now, I ask them, you have to give me strength.
I promise to serve thee, oh my Lord, and I beg thee some mercy.
Alright, I was told to teach you all something else.
Life has become a burden, living in this evil system. Oh, Jah, please stand for me. I cannot make it alone. I need you as my own. Oh, Jah, I call on thee. Some are trying to leave. You are the blue line. For I will be so unwise.
So when this song done, I'm going to be explaining to the world what caused the crack, and you will see for yourself what I'm going to explain to you. So we need to post this live viral, because apparently Facebook is blocking it again. Hey, 5 shares, come on.
You said that I can make my stand, yeah, above the sinking sail. Oh, hey, then you're trying to leave. You out of the line, but I wouldn't be so unwise. And so I promise to serve thee with all my heart. And I'm begging thee mercy. Lord, give me strength.
Alright people, so what I want you to do right now, let's get to share this live. What I'm teaching you all here, people should be paying me, people should be actually paying me to teach them these things, but you know what, it's free, and people still win shirt, but you know what, it's alright, if they share it or they don't share it. What I do is for Elohim. Is teach you some ancient things that you never heard before anywhere else, show you some things that they never heard before, and so on. You know people just pay to learn bullshit, right? People just get paid to fucking learn lies. But I'm teaching you the real truth. But people don't want to learn the real truth. That's the world that we live in, huh? Right. Anyhow, let's get to it now. Alright, so we got a little music in the background there. Alright. Forget about what they want and what they want. First, I want to know if you're not ready. I want to explain. Alright. I want to explain the crack. On the way how it's crack. What caused that crack? Hi to all my guests. To everyone who joined this live today, right? Alright, we've seen that crack here. As you can see with your own eyes. I want to show you something. This is not a new continent, as NASA says, or as scientists says. This will be a new continent. This is not a new continent forming here. Right? I also want to show you all something awesome. So that you'll be able to see also that the angel who split here, you can see the face, the way how they cut out the split, you can see the angel carve out himself. You see, he had to be spiritually awakened. Spiritually awakened to see what I see. What I see, most of you can't see what I'm seeing, right? So I want to show you something secret that other people, scientists, can't see. So I want to show you where the eye is. This will be the eye of the angel. The eye of the angel is right here, and you can see the tears coming down the angel eye. Right? See the tears coming down the angel eye? Now what I'm telling you here might sound crazy, because they're not spiritually awakened, not prepared yet to receive this revelation. Right? So the eye of the angel here, tears of the angel, and you can see the nostrils of the angel. So this is the nostril of the angel. This is the teeth of the angel here. You can see the angel teeth. You can see the bottom lip here. You can see the chin here and the neck down this side. So you're seeing his chin here, and you're seeing his neck structure here. Again, you see the eye of the angel. You see the nostril of the angel here. You see the lip of the angel and the teeth of the angel here, right? You see the teeth here. You see the tongue in the middle. You see the lip of the angel here. You see the lip of the angel here. And you're seeing a little black spot beard. If it look good, you can see the black beard. You can see the angel so angry. Let's see if I can just make that sound again. So, you can see what happening here right now. Everybody should share this live. Because nobody else on the earth could see what I could see. So this was revealed to me just now. To teach everybody what I am seeing now. And what caused the split is Archangel Michael. This is Michael here. Michael, Archangel Michael, known as Michael to you, right? The chief angel in heaven. One of the powerful archangels. This is Michael here, very angry. At Kenya. Whatever evil things that they're doing in Kenya that doesn't please the Almighty, it displeases Elohim's angels. And they execute vengeance against Yah's enemies. So this is what happened here. This is the teeth of the angel, as you can see. You can see from a distance, but I can see. This is the lip of the angel here. And he's spiritually awakened to see this presence. Archangel Michael carved out himself on this crack here. Now this crack here doesn't stop up here. It goes right across the valley, the rift. Not too far from this crack, there's a dormant volcano. So there's a volcano, a dormant volcano, that is currently active, has begun to be active now. Because what would then happen here is Africa, South Africa, Kenya to be exact, is going to split in three. Again, Kenya is going to split in three different parts. And actually that's the same thing that happening all over the world, right? So now you understand is that Archangel Michael took his sword, carved out himself. The split is actually him executing Yahuwah's judgment on Kenya. Kenya is going to split in three. Now this simple split that Archangel Michael make is not a simple thing. What happened here? The land needed to be saturated with water. So if you go back and do the research, you will realize that here once flooded. Once upon a time, here was flooded. So the water saturated here. And able to actually cut the land in a specific way, it had to be saturated with water. So now you know the reason why. Okay, let me say something else. What you're learning here, I hope that you really give credit to me. I hope that I really receive that credit and that you really teach the people, whoever you're going to teach the real truth, that you truly learn it from me and you ain't just fucking pick it up just so. Alright, so the land needs to be saturated first in order to be split. The land can split without being saturated. So it was saturated with water at a month of a time.
I love to see my people living in love. I hate to see them fighting and swimming in blood. Nothing got the farming, scarring in the mud. Yet they wanna be the dirt to read the food as it bought. Oh, them fill the earth with peace and church and quarrel. Love the rum, quarrel. Less food, more shout and more mouth. Oh, Rasta tell them all the why. Stop war from the till the side. Stop fighting for land and all. Feel the coil, so many got defined. So it must have sweet in them face and take that with a smile. The one stop the noise. So my land so fertile, acres more than a zillion mile. People acting wild, pick up your
I have said that that crack would have happened. And people laugh at me. I just said that before the polyversal shift, that there will be certain shifts happening before the polyversal shift. And I also said that it will begin with Trinidad. It has begun with Trinidad, brothers and sisters. Trinidad is cracking right about now. But the Trinidad government, they keep it a secret. Trinidad will be split in three, just as Kenya. All what I'm telling you all, it is written already in prophecy. So don't want anybody to know what's going on. They keep it a secret. A lot of activities going on around the world and they're not telling anybody anything.
Mention. Say a drugs and gun, the people tax money spent for. From with plastic smile and the wicked intention in your hand. I wait them put them evil invention. Turn gun model, seeking attention. See them know you learn and that is no redemption. Parents are wonder where to get the first centrum. The very dirt, them not even got pension. Must I tell them all the why? Stop war on the till the...
So I'm asking a question, a question. When are we going to learn the lies of this world? When are we going to learn the lies of this ungodly system? When are they going to realize who's your true enemy? And the ones who truly try to protect you and release you from the prisons and the dungeons that the enemy have placed you in your own mental state of mind. Yes, mental slavery exists.
So fighting for land and all. Be coil, so many go defile. Say master sitting on them face and take that with a smile. The bones of an oil. So my land's a fertile. Acres more than a zillion mile. The people acting vile. Pick up your neighbor's style. One before one, my proper and child. Love to see my people living.
And then they're talking about them living in love. Are they living in love?
Swimming in love. Nothing but the farming, the scarring.
So it's time to wake up, time to wake up. We think the purpose of the chauffeurs and them song all over the world.
Be the first to pick the fruit as it falls. Oh, lift on the earth and a peace in church and old rose. Love the room bar and them eat the people rose. Them take the mic and cheap and over rago.
So sinkholes are open everywhere.
World out, less food, more mouth and more jolt. Oh yeah, Rasta tell them all the wine. Stop world hunger till the side. Stop fighting for land and oil. Baby coil, so many go defile. Let Rasta speak, you know in case I'm dead. That Twitter smile, the fun stop the noise.
So people think I'm a false prophet.
My lands are fertile, precious more than a zillion miles.
Yeah!
Then pick up your neighbor's line. One before one, mama, papa, and
child.
On the kingdom of darkness. Let's expose what's been hidden and what needs to be revealed. If only we have more people interested in the ancient truth, than interested in their own flesh, than interested in their own desire, and interested in being famous in their flesh. There are so much of people running around like grasshoppers, spreading lies and propaganda against the kingdom of Elohim. The kingdom of Elohim is being persecuted, yes, for righteousness' sake. And for the holy, divine, and set apart names of righteousness. People are asking, how much longer, how much longer? But you are not ready to accept responsibility. Because when you become one with the triune eternal family, you have responsibilities. You have roles that you need to attend to and walk in total alignment with the kingdom of Elohim.
Akadosh Baruch Hu.
The day of the Lord is so near, but people refuse to listen to their divine messenger, their only divine messenger. There are other messengers, yes, of Elohim, but there's only one divine messenger on this earth, and it is myself. Though some people might say, how you can be a divine messenger, or you can be the only divine messenger. I am the only divine messenger, and I haven't lied of who I am. I have shown the world the power of Elohim through me. I've shown them miracles. I've opened the heavens. I have bring down the sun. I've risen the sun. I've cleared the skies. I have prophesied things that no man, woman, nor child have seen. Nor have they heard the voice of the Creator. Nor have they known the unknown things of this earth. I have spoken things that nobody else on this earth have received. No, I'm not bluffing. And yes, I am boasting. Because I can boast of righteousness. I can boast in righteousness. Boast of what the Creator have done through me. But many people refuse to walk in righteousness. Refuse to live in
in holiness. How could you be accepted in the kingdom of Elohim if you are living unrighteous? If you are wallowing in your own sins and darkness and want what your flesh wants but want not what the Holy Spirit wants for you. Imaya. How could you call yourselves children of God but yet you don't want to live holy? You want to follow all the lifestyles of this world and want to throw on the garment of unrighteousness, and you want to appear before a holy God, the holies of holies, but yet your life is not in sync with Elohim. You want to steal the remnants from Elohim, and you want to put on the cloak of righteousness, but yet you don't want to walk in righteousness. You want to cloak yourself in darkness, but yet you're trying to hold on to unrighteousness. Who you think you are fooling? With one mouth, with one tongue. You say, Lord, we will obey. And with your heart, you blaspheme his holy name. And then behind closed doors, you live according to this paganistic world. You celebrate all the pagan holidays you celebrate. And then you call yourself a child of God. Then you give yourself a title. All of a sudden you give yourself titles. Calling yourself prophet this and calling yourself prophetess that. But you're not walking in holiness. You have a Facebook page dedicated for your flesh, not dedicated for righteousness. Your heart is not in sync with Elohim, the creators. Almighty God, your heart is not in sync with righteousness. But yet you have a Facebook page. And yet you put up as if you are holy. And you call yourself prophetess. You give yourself even messenger. But you are no messenger of Elohim. No messenger of righteousness. You are a messenger of unrighteousness. A messenger of your own destruction. But when you are put to the test, you fail. You fail miserably. All because you want what your flesh wants. It's all about what your flesh wants, not what the holy Ruach wants. Are you not ashamed of yourselves? You who call yourself messenger. You who call yourself prophets. You who call yourself deacons. You who call yourself children of God. Are you not ashamed? Are you not ashamed of what you have become? In the eyes of the Creator, He sees you as filthy garments. Yet you claim to walk in God's righteousness. Yet you claim to walk in holiness. Are you not ashamed? Are you not ashamed? You who call yourself children, who give yourself titles, but yet you cannot do a simple task for the kingdom. You call yourself a messenger. You call yourself somebody who claiming to be above God. Did God the Almighty give you that title? Who gave you that title? Where did that title you suffered from? Stop misleading God's children. Stop misleading them in your own desires. Because you want to be famous on Facebook. Because you want to be famous on YouTube and Twitter. You want to be famous on social media. You want to have a voice for your own desire. But no voice for the Creator. Because you do not speak on behalf of our Creator. You speak on behalf of the devil. Your flesh is misleading you down the road to destruction. And there's only one way out for you. Only one way out for you. But that is if you choose to live righteous. If you choose to live holy. It's only if you choose.
You're not serious about work. You walk with righteousness. You're not serious. People are not serious nor ready to be taken up. But as Yah have told me, and as Yah have spoken already, only those who are righteous will be taken. Only those who are righteous will be taken. Those who are set apart in righteousness will be taken. Those who live according to the flesh, you will remain to suffer your iniquities. I know you don't like to hear that. You don't like to hear the truth. You don't like to hear what is on the heart of our father, nor our mother. You have rejected righteousness, yet you claim to walk in holiness before all creators. But you are only fooling yourselves. Oh, you love Elohim, you love Elohim, but yet you don't want to walk in holiness. Oh, are you not the same of your sins before holy God? For you are liars. You are lying. Your sins are so much above your heads. You think that God do not see. You think that they do not know your secret sins. Oh, you profess with your mouth, but deep down in your heart you hate God. You hate their righteousness. You hate their truth. You hate who they are. You hate because you love darkness rather than love the true light of our creators. You are same. You are some. You are scum before the creators. You have scammed my people, says the Lord. You have scammed them. You have drawn them far away from my presence, says the Lord. You have weakened my plans to save my people, says the Lord. My vengeance is so upright. If only you hear me. If only you listen and hearken to my messenger. The word that I speak is so divine, but yet you choose to walk in your own flesh and not hear what the Lord has said. Know what the Lord speaks. You are foolish in your own ways. Oh Israel, you are foolish in your own ways. For when I have spoken, you refuse to hearken. So therefore my anger has turned up and pent up with vengeance against you. I shall not spare you, O Israel, but I shall spare those who hearken unto my voice, or those who live according to my standards, and those who live according to the commandments that I, Yahushua, the El Elyon, have commanded. Or those who hear, Esmai El Israel. You are foolish in your own ways. You are walking in your own ways, pretending to walk in my righteousness. But here I call you out. You will witness my anger. You will witness my wrath. I'm so weary in keeping in this anger. The burdens that you have placed upon my shoulders and all that you have done against me. Oh Israel, children who supposed to be preparing for Zion, preparing to enter the New Jerusalem. You are foolish in your own ways. You are foolish in your own ways, Israel. Therefore, my punishment shall be great against you. Israel, you are foolish in your own ways. Your worship before me is not needed. Those who are righteous and holy and set apart. Blessed are those that will endure this punishment till the end. And they shall know that El Elyon, Yahuwah, El Barashem, delivered those who are righteous. Israel, you are
are foolish in your own ways. For I have set a path before you, but you haven't took the path that I've set before you, Israel. You are foolish in your own ways. Now I bring a punishment against you, Israel, for you refuse to listen to me. Unto my voice, Israel. You are foolish in your own ways. I shall bring a drought upon you, Israel. A drought that you will never ever recover from. Oh, Israel, you're supposed to be preparing to meet me in the New Jerusalem. But you are busy. Busy bodies, busy trying to make something of yourselves in this ungodly world. Shame on you who call yourself ministers. Shame on you who call yourself prophets. Shame on you who have gone back to your ungodly ways. Shame on you. For I shall bring now a curse upon you, Israel, because you refuse to hearken. For I have given you your time to repent and change your ways, Israel, but you refuse. You refuse my correction. You refuse my direction, Israel. Shame on you, Israel. Shame on you who call yourselves mine. Shame on you. Yet you walk in your demigod standards, which is no standards of righteousness. Yeah, O Israel, you have disappointed me, and you have hurt me so deep, Israel. You are a disappointment, Israel. You are a disappointment to me. You have hurt me so deep because you have turned back to your ungodly ways, Israel. You will not be priest unto me, but you shall be a reproach. A reproach unto your veterans and unto your sisters. For I shall not represent you, Israel. You have turned against me. You have spit in my face. You who have tried to drive a sword to my back. You who I've helped. You who I've prospered. You, Israel. I speak to all nationalities. All people. Israel, you have disappointed me. Shame on all of you who call yourself masters. Shame on all of you who call yourself ministers and prophets and deacons and evangelists and prophetess. And shame on all of you, for you are workers of darkness, not workers of righteousness. I shall punish you, all of you who call yourselves mine, yet do not walk in my ordinances, nor in my righteousness. I shall punish you, and your punishment shall be greater than 100-folds. I have shown mercy. I have shown mercy unto you, Israel. I have chosen you as a people to represent me on the earth. But you have turned greatly against me, Israel. Have you not seen my tears as it floods out the nations? How much more shall I bear? Oh, my anger is pent up against you. You call yourselves mine. You're a disappointment. A disappointment. A disappointment. A disappointment. I'm so fed up of your ways, your ungodly ways. You who call yourselves mine. I'm fed up of holding in my anger for you, Israel. For I have already chosen those who I will take, who I will rescue from my father's judgment and wrath. If you do not believe, it's I, Yahushua, who speaks unto you. How much signs shall I show you again, Israel? For I have died for you and given myself for you, Israel. spoken, or a gospel I have never preached. Oh, my anger is bent up against you, you who call yourself ministers of a gospel, and I have never preached, nor have I ever spoken. You have misled my people. You have misled those that I've sent to you to direct to me. You have made yourself gods. Desolation shall creep upon you, for you seek not refuge in righteousness. You seek no refuge in Elohim's love. You seek no refuge in Elohim's tent. You shall be barren and made naked, and everything that we have restored or given unto you shall be stripped away from you. No, let your oppressors oppress you. Let your oppressors oppress you. Because you refuse to obey me. Because you refuse to walk in our holiness and righteousness, Israel. I shall no more bear your burdens, Israel. For now thou shalt see. My true intentions is to save those who are holy. My intention is to save those who are righteous. No need to hide. No need to hide in this hour. There is nowhere to hide, nowhere to run. The coming year, 2018. For I shall shut my ear to your cries, Israel. You must suffer what you have done against me. You must suffer, Israel. For you have spoken great abominations against Elohim. You shall and you will suffer. For I shall no more bear your burdens. The judgment of the Most High is drawing nearer. Are you ready for what is coming? Or what it will, or what will happen? Are you ready? Those who are righteous, I speak to. I speak not to those who are unrighteous and walking in their flesh and living according to the ungodly standards of this world. I speak unto those who are living righteous. Those who walk the walk and talk the talk. How much more warnings shall be sent? How much more warnings there shall be? How much more warnings? How much more signs? Behold, a greater shift, a greater magnetic shift is coming. Man refused to listen. Mankind refused to obey. They refuse instruction. Stubborn. Rebellious. Ungodly. Unrighteous. Unwilling to sacrifice anything for Elohim's kingdom. Don't call yourself messengers. Don't give yourself title. You ain't no messengers. You're not no messenger unless you are living holy, living righteous. Unless you have accepted the baptism of the true Holy Spirit. Then you can call yourself a messenger. When you start to obey Elohim, stop pretending. Yeah.
glory.
Israel.
Sing to Adonai a new song.
Sing
to Hashem, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim the good news of the salvation of David.
Sing to the Lord a brand new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim from day to day his salvation.
Wonders among all peoples. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, the Lord made the heavens.
Lift up your heads, and
you lifted up the heavens and the
glory.
And the King of Glory shall come down. Who is this King of Glory?
Yahushua HaMashiach.
Oh, 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 o
Nobody wants to be famous on Facebook. Nobody wants the truth. People are really holding on to the truth. It's all about what they could get from you. If they could get your support and they're teaching shit, but you're still going along with this shit. And it's not even drawing you nearer to Elohim at all. You are being misled and misguided by these ministers, by these prophets, by these deacons, by those who call themselves holy. Wake up, Israel! Live righteous according to the standard of Elohim. Because the great day of judgment is coming. Coming 2018, the beginning of great suffering upon humanity. Attest to see those who will truly stand for righteousness, sir. Those who will truly walk according to the standards of holiness, sir. Oh, Samayak, Israel, hear the voice of Elohim's divine messenger. Hearken your ear to the words that he speaks. For he speaks from the heart of the Creator, from the bosom of their love. All others, ministers, prophets, and deacons, they all speak in their flesh. They operate in divination and witchcraft. They operate not in the anointing of our Creator. Oh, wake up, Israel. You are being misled to destruction. Because the way of the Lord is not in you. And the righteousness of our Creator is not in your heart to serve Him in spirit and in truth. Wake up, Israel. For the Lord has declared His judgment and anger and vengeance and displease against you. Make it right, Israel. For the Lord who stands strong and mighty is about to judge you for your iniquities. The Most High, El Elyon, the Father, the Potter, O Christ, Israel, awaken in righteousness and serve our Creator in spirit and in truth. Because He's about to judge you. Because you are comfortable in your sins, in your comfort zones, He's about to uproot you. Uproot you from that comfort zone that you are in. And the earth is about to rock to and fro like a drunkard. And Yellowstone is about to give birth. Because it is overdue and it is what it has been withheld or withhold from destroying you, Israel. Oh, the Lord is merciful and showed mercy unto you, Israel. But you have angered Him. You have angered Him. You have blasphemed His holy name. And you have spoken things that He haven't spoken. Nor have He spoken. Nor the devices in His heart. Oh, ministers who call themselves ministers. The Most High Elohim is about to bring you low. And desolation is about to follow your congregation. Your congregation is about to be stripped of everything that you have stolen from the Most High. Oh, run for your lives, you who seek refuge in the churches of men. Run for your lives. Run for your lives, you who seek refuge in men, rather than seek refuge in Elohim.
Like you know, son.
Of glory.
את הבטוחים, הפתוחות כנפי
from Iran, whether you're from Texas or any part of United States, whether you are from the Caribbean, any part of the Caribbean, whether you are from South America, South Africa, wherever you are, this will be the opportunity to worship with the angels. The way the angels worship in heaven. And the music or the songs that is being played or accepted by our Father. Shamayak, Israel, awake! Awake, Israel! For your enemies are persecuting you, not in righteousness. Oh, you who call yourself ministers of the gospel that Yahushua have never spoken. He will take vengeance against you. For his wrath is long overdue. Oh, Shamayak, Israel, awake. Awake now. Awake, you who call yourself children of Zion. Awake. Haven't you seen the Lord have hold back? He has hold back his wrath, hold back his anger, and he has shown you mercy, Israel, because he wants you to get it right. But yet you refuse to walk in his holiness. Israel, what a shame. What a shame, Israel. May your oppressors continue to oppress you. And the plagues that they have created to devour you, shall that be your portion? You who walk in unrighteousness. Lakurdaim Elohim. Yahushua Hamashiach, he is king. Shout it with me. Yahushua Hamashiach, he is king. Yahushua is king. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords. The one who have died for us, who have given everything, who have given up everything for us, whose sacrifice is well-being for us. No other man, no other being have sacrificed anything for you. No idols have sacrificed anything for you. It's not worth it, Israel. It's not worth it being thrown into hell. It's not worth it, Israel. It's not worth it, Israel. Only those who are set apart, those who are set apart will rise. Will rise to sit with Yahushua. Will be invited to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Your life is too basically fit on doing things that is ungodly. Only those who are set apart in righteousness, you will be called up. You will be called up. Your names will be written. Your name is written in the golden Lamb's book of life. Shamayak El Elyon. Arise, Yahuwah. Arise, Yahuwah. We call out to thee in this hour. Shamayak El Elyon. Yahuwah, our Father. We cry out to you, Abba Father. Our enemies have plotted against us, your righteous ones. They have blasphemed and spoken lies against us, O Lord Most High. Oh, we glorify Rabbi. We glorify Rabbi. We worship you, Elohim. We glorify Rabbi. We, all the angels, we glorify Rabbi. We worship you, Elohim, our Creator. Yerushalayim, Yerushalayim is here. Yerushalayim is here. The New Jerusalem, as you know it in English, is here.
and the scientists, sky watchers, the sky observers, NASA, your government, your secret agencies, shadow government, the Anunnaki, the ETs, the reptilians, they know that Shemayak, Yerushalayim, has arisen and soaring her glory, soaring her glory all over the earth in the heavens. Hey, open your ear, Israel. Oh, Rabbi Sakaya, Sakaya, Sakaya. May your Sakanya glory overflow in this hour, Mama Imaya. Laka Uraim Basam. Where's everyone? Oh, yeah. Woo. Elohim is here. Not in the flesh, but in the spirit. And they are soaring the glory. They are soaring the glory. Don't let them continue to fool you. Don't let them continue to brainwash you. Awake, Israel. Awake, for you are particular people. A treasure people before our creators. Awake, Israel. Oh, please awake. Awake and hear the plead of the angels. Awake. Your souls is worth more than gold. Israel, oh Israel, awake, for the judgment of our Creator is against you, the judgment of our Father is against you, the judgment of our Mother is against you. Awake, Israel, awake before it's too late, for great shall be the punishment of those who refuse to obey, or those who continue to walk in their flesh. Only, and those who refuse to listen. Look at Indonesia. Look at the floods. Look at Spain. Look at Greenland. Look at all these places that are flooding out. All these places that are experiencing a supernatural destruction of Yahuwah's wrath. How much more shall I bear with you, Israel? For you are rebellious against your creators. A great shift is coming. A great shift. A shift so great that it will shake you out of your flesh, you foolish ones. What will you do then when that shift occurs? Again, a great shift is coming. A shift so great that it will shake you out of your flesh. But it will be no escape for you. Although you are shaken out of your flesh, for seeing what will happen upon the earth, or what will occur in different parts of the earth. Rakuk Gilanevesa. Hear, O Israel, the voice of Elohim's true, divine messenger. Hear, O Israel, he who has the power to rise the sun. He who has the power to turn day into night. Or he who all authority has given. O King Yahushua, Hamashiach, our true divine, eternal Hamashiach. Give it all. Ha! Kadosha! Uwiseh Baba Yahuwah. Yeah!
very small earthquakes means that a big earthquake is going to happen, and that will be the plates, the shifting of the tectonic plates. Elohim, Adonai, we cry out to you, Father, and we ask you, Father, to remove us. Remove us, Father. You have shown so much mercy, so much mercy, even unto the wicked. You have poured out your hearts unto them, Yahushua, and they respect not your authority. I beseech you, even now, Father, and hear the cries of your true children, those who love you. May we all be filled with your spirit, Imaya, filled with your wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that concerns you. Teach us your ways. Teach us your ways, Elohim. Shall Yah show you how much more mercy? How much more mercy shall Yah show you? What a great shift is coming. A shift so great that will shake you out of your flesh. But it will be too late for you to transfigure and understand the things of the Spirit, or understand the manifestation of Yah's love through the divine transformation that is coming with a shift. A transformation is coming. A transformation is coming. Don't sit there and type amen. Don't sit there and type anything that your flesh wants you to type. From your heart, say what's on your heart. Tectonic shift. Hallelujah.
There's a lot to take place, you know. There's a whole lot to take place, and I'm just giving you updates, brothers and sisters. You know, I'm just giving you the updates I'm just giving you the updates of what to expect. Oh, you know. So just like how this rainbow is here, well, the earth is flat. The earth has four pillars, which is the four poles, which is the east, the west, the north, the south pole. So the four pillars represent the four poles. So you all understand, right? You all understand that the four poles that they're talking about, the North Pole, the West Pole, the East Pole, the North Pole, well, I say North already. The North, the East, West, North, South. Four pillars, you see my hands? Four pillars, four poles. The East, West, North, South. Four pillars hold this earth together, stationary. When Yahuwah decides to remove the plates, so you want us to go to the box now? When Yahuwah decides to remove the plates, and when he decides to remove, when he decides to lock the plates together with the fault line, that brings about a wobble. Not only a wobble, but there must be a magnitude of earthquakes. How earthquakes are caused is because Yahuwah is the creator, and he designed the earth a specific way. And when he's ready, he could just choke a certain part. He could just take his staff and just choke a certain part, and that will start the earthquake. When I say choke a certain part, you know what I mean? Like if you have let me just demonstrate something to you all here with a little branch I have here. This is a branch I have here. This is the earth here. When Yahuwah decides that he want to cause an earthquake, this is what he does. This is Yahuwah. This is Yahuwah's staff. This example, this is Yahuwah's staff. And Yahuwah takes his staff and just point it in a specific place. Let me say Yahuwah take his staff and he pointed in a specific place, like is the West Coast or in the Atlantic Ocean. Yahuwah take his staff and he put it in that place. It will cause an earthquake because he hit it, bram. And that will cause an earthquake. Right? But if Yahuwah does do it a little likely, it will cause a 3.1 or a 6.1. But if Yahuwah does it in a very tough way, okay, let me demonstrate it differently. Let me draw it for you to see what I'm talking about. Because these days, I need to draw. So I can draw it fast. I'm going to draw it. I saw it a lot of people. Okay. Whew. I see it. All right. So yesterday, I want to explain to every one of you. I don't know if you can see it. I hope that you can see it. I'm sure if you can see it. Yeah. Let's see if I can do it. So I'm going to draw it now. I don't know if you can see it. I hope you can see it. Let me know if you've seen it clear. We have a lot to teach today. So every single day as we draw closer, I will teach you all some more deeper things that science cannot explain. But I can explain it, right? So this is the crop circles here, which I talked about last night. I'm going to draw. Now I'm going to draw on a new page. This is ABBA staff here. ABBA staff. And I'm going to show you all how earthquake starts. Well, the next time I show you all how storm starts. ABBA staff. Oh Lord. Opposite. This is ABBA staff. I join it differently, yeah? So don't laugh at my drawing. Let me see how it is. Look like this. Right. And it have this on it. This is ABBA staff here.
Location, Dominican
Republic
region, plus minor, magnitude,
3.2,
32 minutes ago.
This is ABBA staff here. This is heaven. This is heaven. Down here is a typical here, right? So, this ABBA staff, this heaven is it. Because Earth is flat, Earth is flat. Heaven is flat also too, right? If he made us in his image, therefore he made the kingdom, he made the earth just like the way how it is in heaven. But he told us not to worship anything that is made or anything that is carved out. He told us not to worship these things. So this is ABBA staff here, ABBA staff, and this is the earth. So this is the, I'll put here the south, east, west, sorry about that, this will be west. East-west, this will be north. This will be north pole, and this will be south. Watch and learn. So watch and learn here. Watch and learn what's actually taking place. This ABBA staff here. This heaven, this is it. So we will go to the north. Right now where I am is this, right? So we go to the north, and the north will be on this side. Isn't this west? Is not, so the mountain is on this side. Alright. So the earth flat just like this book. Right? Just like how this sketches, it's flat like this. Right? The earth have a similarity, but that's not how the earth is, right? The earth flat like this. This is in order to get a east, a west, a north, a south pole, the earth must be flat. It must be like a box. The new Yerushalayim is also like a box. Right? The new Yerushalayim is also like a box, and it have a dome over the new Yerushalayim. Now I'll explain about that a little later on in this live, right? So here we have earth, here we have the east, the west, the north, the south, right? Here we have these north poles, here we have these poles going to shift. So the north pole is going to come where, the north pole is going to come where the west pole is, and the south pole is going to come where the east pole is. To accomplish that, this is what needs to be done. To accomplish, I think it's this book. I think it's this book here. Right, so to accomplish the shift, you see I saw the heaven stuff, right? To accomplish the shift, hold on now, Ryan, hold on now, let me teach you the truth. Brian, let me teach you the truth, bro. Right? This is not science. And this is not science, this is not religion, and this is certainly not bullshit. Right? Let me teach you the truth. And I will explain to you where to get a theory from. Right? Okay, so this is it. This is ABBA rod. And in order to accomplish a shift, a pole shift, let me put pole shift. So right again. So in order to complete, to bring a pole shift to Earth, yeah, this is it. In order to bring a pole shift to Earth. Sorry about my effective. ABBA staff, Earth, pole shift, Yellowstone, they all correspond together. Ryan Maxing, this is for you, bro. See the plates here? See the fault lines? Trinidad have fault lines running through the north and the south. Right, Trinidad have fault lines running through the north and the south. I'm not sure about the east or the west. America have fault lines running everywhere. Fault lines running zigzag. So what is going to happen, brothers and sisters? What is going to happen here?
Location,
is the plate, Myanmar, the two plates is going to squeeze
rock,
the fault line,
light,
causing the land to be pulled into the sea. Watch, causing the land to be pulled into the sea. Causing the magnitude of earthquake needs to be 10.1 or above or below. A great magnitude of earthquake, 10.1, right? Earthquake, great magnitude of earthquake, 10.1 will give you a wobble here. That will cause a major tsunami, a major tsunami to happen right here. Just let me know if you've seen it clear or you're not seeing it clear. I don't want to waste my time again. I'm not going to waste my time if nobody's not seen it. If they're not seen it blurred, or if you've seen it blurred, let me know. So we'll move on to other things. Let me know right now if you've seen it blurred. All right. Clear? Very good. Very, thanks. All right, okay. If it's clear, praise yeah. So the 10.1 magnitude earthquake, which is going to happen very soon, a 10.1 magnitude earthquake, going to affect Yellowstone. And when, since Yellowstone is a female, I explain about the solar eclipse. As you can see,
Location,
this is solar eclipse here.
Western Turkey,
and this is Elohim, and there are veins running from the land to the Atlantic Ocean, connecting back to Yellowstone. And from Yellowstone, connecting back to the sinkholes, right? All these sinkholes, just a little blow, let's pray against it, right? You see what I put SH means sinkhole, right? That is the sinkhole, and the R is for righteous. So before Yellowstone blows, the caldera of Yellowstone is the heart of Yellowstone. Watch and learn. Revelation 12 is in response to Yellowstone eruption. So your brothers and sisters, the enemy will try to stop this, but this cannot be stopped. Only Elohim can fulfill this. So the veins is running from this country, to all countries connected together.
Location,
right?
23 kilometers west, northwest,
right? All
Middleton,
countries connected together.
Alaska,
and as
minor,
you can see,
magnitude,
the mountains, the land,
ago.
That includes all mountains. Not because I draw two, doesn't mean to say only two going to be affected. All the earth is going to be affected, right? Yahuwah is going to pull in the earth is going to be pulled in, like pulled in, and when the wobble takes place here, the fault line is already between the two plates, right? The fault line is more than two plates, right? But I just explained two plates here, so I can understand. It has to be more than two plates because it, two plates alone cannot hold for two nations or just a few. So it's more than two plates, it's seven plates. There's seven plates in all. So there are seven plates, and there are also seven fault lines. There are also seven beams. And seven is completion of the kingdom of Yahushua HaMashiach. Right? So again, plates, fault lines, mountains, land, Yellowstone, female. Right? This is the guy, the G is for the geysers, or the Giaz, whatever they call it. And this is the womb of Yellowstone. Before Yellowstone erupts, like you have a question, ask me. If you have a question, please ask me. One person at a time, please. If you have a question, ask me. Again, there are seven veins, seven plates, seven fault lines, seven holding everything together. Everything together. When Yahuwah created, that is why this all corresponds to the Shabbat. This all corresponds to the Shabbat also too. So when Yahuwah finishes work, on the sixth day, Yahuwah rests on the seventh day, because seven is completion of his creation. And when Yahuwah created the earth, Yellowstone was created. And with Yellowstone, other volcanoes started to pop up other places on the earth. So back to explaining this, this may be one of the most difficult things to explain to human beings. That is Elohim is the one who's in charge of this whole process. So the magnitude 10.1, Yahuwah needs to hit his rod. Yahuwah needs to hit his staff, or his rod, you see, Abba's staff. He needs to hit it hard here. So if Abba hits it, let me say mild, let me just say Abba hits here mild. I'm going to put mild. His mild could be a 3.1, sorry. His mild could be a 3.1 magnitude. That will cause a magnitude of earthquake. So if Abba decides to hit a certain part of the earth, that is in the west. Let's say Abba decides to hit the north with an earthquake. He will be hitting here. Kinda, or mild. See, I put mild up here. Kinda means that they will get around 4.4, or maybe they will get around they will get about 5.4. Right? If Abba decides to hit here with the staff, the earth 3.1 mild, that is in the west, and in the north, he hits in the north kinda, you'll get 4.4 earthquake. If Abba decides now in south to take his staff up here and hit the south, let's say he hit the south hard, but not too hard, but hard but mild. Let me just wait. Abba, sorry about that. Equal shift, right? Abba hit here hard but mild. You will get something like a 6.1.
You'll
get like a 5.
Western Turkey. Minus 7 minutes to go.
Oh, this is what I'm telling you. Yeah? This is what Abba is telling me right now. So what you are being taught is what is being taught to me right now. This is new things that's being taught to me right now. So when Abba takes his staff, and this is how earthquakes start. Go study science and the bullshit. That's bullshit. Abba created the earth. He know how to cause earthquakes. He uses staff, his rod, and knock here. Abba take his staff and he knock the west. The west will get 3.1 because it's a mile. He take his rod again and he hit the north, or he can hit both places. Wham, wham at the same time. Let me just draw something to show you all. And that can happen. So this happens here. Created an earthquake. That created an earthquake in the epicenter of the earth. Not really the epicenter, but the center of the earth here. This is the epicenter. And I'm going to show you all how we are in the center of the universe. We are the attraction of the universe. Everybody in the universe knows who we are here, right? And they know there's a dome here. The dome, since the earth is like this, this is the model of the earth. The earth is not like this wrong, flat. The earth is not flat like this. No, that is not flat, right? That is certainly not flat. The earth is like this. This is how the earth is. That is how you can be able to get the west and north and so forth. You cannot get it any other way, right? So, Abba up here, and you get 4.4, 5.4 magnitude of it. Let's say Abba decides to hit east. And he hit the east very hard. Very hard. If you hit the east very hard, you'll get a 7. Did I say 7? Yeah. You'll get a 7.8. Or, according to the hit, you could get a 10.1 magnitude of earthquake. Very hard. 10.8 magnitude, right? So again, I will explain it again. This is Abba's staff. This is what he used to bring forth the earthquakes on the earth. He used his staff and knock a certain place. So this 34 shift will happen. So let me go over to this sketch. Watch and learn. The vein, I'll tell you all, is set up 7 veins, 7 plates, 7 fault lines. Right, the plates actually mean the shelves, so it has 7 shelves, which is actually the plates. So the plate is the shelves, right? The plate is the shelf. So when Abba hits here, the east very hard, you will either get a 7.8 or a 10.1 that could cause a tsunami here. If Abba hit the earthquake on the land, houses here, all here will be destroyed because the 10.1 will bring forth a devastation. So a 10.1 earthquake will bring about a devastation, causing a tsunami according to if it hits in the Atlantic Ocean. As you can see, I have 10.1 here. If it hits in the Atlantic Ocean, you will get a wobble here, which means a tsunami will happen right here, causing the land to flood out, causing the plates to uplift, or the shelves to uplift, to pour in the water onto the land. That is how a tsunami happens. A tsunami doesn't happen, the earthquake hit it and it caused a wave and that's how the wave comes. You know, brothers and sisters, they're lying to us because they cannot explain to you all here what I'm explaining to you, right? Scientists cannot explain this. They will never explain it to you because they don't want you to know. They want to keep you under the deception because that's part of the plan, to keep you blinded, to keep you under control, their control. So they will tell you, what I'm telling you here, the information I'm telling you here, worth more than $1 billion, right? But this is not for sale. This is not for sale. This is for, not even for educational purposes. This is for those who love righteousness, who want to learn about the truth, right? Doing all this is not a waste of my time. For all those who reject this, then they should go with NASA and die with NASA. They don't deserve to be in Elohim's presence if they reject this model of heaven, how it was created, right? If you don't like how I just speak, that you blasted business too, right? So the plates, the fault lines, the vein is between 2.4, the fault lines. The plates, the two plates. This is actually what's happening right now. So I draw exactly what you're seeing here, right? This is exactly what you're seeing here, right? The plates, the fault lines, the vein, right? Everything corresponds to a tsunami. That's what caused a tsunami. When the earthquake is 10.1, 6.3, that could cause a tsunami according to where it has been focused on hitting. If ABBA hits the rod here, then here, then the wave here, since it's close to the plates, that will cause a major tsunami. But if it happened in the Atlantic Ocean, it will only flow in like a flow of water on the land. But if ABBA hits the stuff here close to the plates, then the shelves will raise up, fly up, wham! And then the fault line squeeze together between the plates, it will cause like a flow up and flow down. So when the when that happens, the water goes up and then it comes back down before the plates goes back down, and then the water gush into the land. But if ABBA hits at 10.1 here or here closer to the plates, my brothers and sisters, that could cause a major tsunami. You're talking about 200 to 700 feet of water coming on the land. It will destroy everything. That land will never recover. You know why? Because of the magnitude of water come in, it will never recover. So this is how it is, brothers and sisters. This is how it is. Don't let them continue to fool you and tell you shit. Or rob you of wisdom, of understanding. This model, this is exactly how ABBA told me it is. And this is how it is, and that's how it is. It doesn't matter to what the other flat earthers think or what the other globalists think. I don't care what they think. What ABBA says, that's what I'm doing, exactly what ABBA says. Right? And some of you might say, what if that's not ABBA? What if that is ABBA? This is how it is. This is the truth. This is the ancient truth from the foundation. This is what was ABBA plan. ABBA plan, this is the foundational plan. This is ABBA rod. And I'll show you all the pole shift. I'm going to just show you all something here. A pole shift. I'm going to show you all when a pole shift will happen. The pole shift will happen when a 10.1 earthquake hits the earth at the same time by the fault line. So 2.10.1, that will equal to 11.1. Sorry, 11.2. So that will be equal to 11.2 earthquake on the land and in the sea. That will cause a major earthquake, and that will cause the poles to shift because of the magnitude of earthquake. The poles here will start to go crazy. Not the poles here, sorry. The plates will lift so high that it will obstruct the land, cause landslides and all these sort of things will happen. Landslides will happen, and the earth will be pulled in into the Atlantic Ocean, and that is the plan of ABBA. Right, so there you have it, ABBA's rod, right? And in Maya, Ruach HaKodosh, let me explain that now. The solar, on the night of the solar eclipse, on the day of the solar eclipse, the heavens will be very ripe, right? On the night of the solar eclipse, the heavens will be very ripe, right? And Elohim, they will open the heavens on the solar eclipse. You will see the new Yerushalayim. Where is it? Okay, Facebook, you don't need to blow it out. I had enough of your shit, okay? Facebook, you don't need to blow it out. They're seeing, they know. I'm just doing this over again. Right? So, yes, the 10.1 earthquake, I'm just saying, Renata, the 10.1 earthquake will bring about a pole shift. It must happen in the sea and on land. And when that happens, oh yes, and that will cause water to come in here, and it will lift the poles. The poles will be lifted, and the earth will flip. When they talk about flip, it doesn't mean like flip like this, you know. When it say it will be a pole flip, or the earth will flip, it doesn't mean nothing. I'm sorry about that. Hold on a second. Just so we can see that about it. When they mean pole, that the earth will flip, it means that it won't flip like this, you know, like a flipping this pen, you know. It means that it will just do so. It will just, like, let me say, how I have it here, the west, the east, but then that will happen. This is what will happen. Let me say that's a compass. This is what will happen to bring about the pole shift. The east will go where the north is, the west will go where the south is. So it will switch up. Talking about devastation here. The poles will shift up. Right, so the earth will leave the land like Trinidad. Trinidad will leave and float away where the west is. Australia will go where the north is. America will go where the east is. And so on. South Africa and all the other places. South Africa will go, I don't know where it actually is, but I'm just saying, right? South Africa will go in the south, right? I just explained it in that way so you can understand. That's what it means by pole flip or the pole shift. The pole shift is actually the seventh shift, or the seventh wave. So the pole shift is the seventh wave. Okay, the seventh wave. Now, I'm going to draw a different diagram to show you something. I don't need to draw it here. Let's see if I can do it here. So I don't think you're ready. On the solar eclipse, see, I'll just do some. I will sketch it for you to understand. On the solar eclipse, that day will be the sixth wave. I think I have it here. Let's see what it is. I think I have it. On the day of the solar eclipse, that will be the sixth wave. That means that the sixth trumpet will sound. Alright? The sixth trumpet will sound on that day. And they say right after that. They say not too long after that, maybe in September. Then we have the seventh wave. Then we have the seventh wave happening here, which could bring about the pole shift. Or pole reversal shift. When they say pole reversal, it doesn't mean the earth could be flipped upside down. They have a different understanding, and that's not how it is. Okay? The west will be where the south is, the east will be where the north is. That is the pole shift. That is the pole reversal shift. And that's how the pole shift will happen on a flat earth. If you're living on a globe, however, let me say there's a globe. Let me say there's a globe model here. There's a globe here. We're living on this piece of shit. Right? We're living on this piece of shit. Which we're not living on this piece of shit. There is no poles on this. You can't get east, you can't get west, you can't get north, and you can't get south. You cannot get a south pole on a friggin' ball. Right? If I can show you what we're talking about, eh? You cannot get a pole shift on a friggin' ball. The earth, this is the earth here, the so-called scientist earth, rubbish, complete rubbish. You cannot get a pole shift on a ball, or on a globe. You can only get it on a flat earth, and this is flat earth. Right, you can only get a pole shift on a flat earth. You cannot get a pole shift on a globe. The earth, we'll put the globe. You cannot get a pole shift there. And if an earthquake happens on this, it will split the crate. The earth will be split. Any earthquake happen, any magnitude of earthquake happens, it will split this globe in half, and then the other half will float away. In space. This is shit. This model is shit. The earth is not friggin', it's not a ball. The earth is not a ball. Or it's not a globe. You're not living on a globe. This is wrong. This is rubbish. This is complete rubbish. Right? This is rubbish. You cannot get, you cannot even get four poles on this. Okay? So there you have it, brothers and sisters. this model of the earth is rubbish. This model of the earth is right. You could only get a pole shift on this model, on a flat earth. On a flat earth, you could get this to happen, a pole shift. And on a flat earth, you could get Yellowstone. And when Yellowstone explodes, it's going to split the dome. The dome is going to be cracked in half. Right? So when Yellowstone explodes, it's going to crack. It's going to split the dome right? So teaching you all here the ancient truth of Elohim. The reason for the sinkholes. Invite some people. Make sure you share. This live. And if you're new and you want to learn more, send my friend request. But please, when you send my friend request, please send my message, a private message. Before you send my friend request, send my private message stating that you're interested in learning.
If I you feel where the cap, then I you will have it. When you say round me, I talk about lion. I you will see Lassie, I the power of the giant. The eagle and the dragon and the bear are spit fire, but they can't overthrow the conquering lion.
Listen, say now. Listen to the voice of the people. Today Rome will burn. And me alone, as the over evil. Say today Rome will burn.
No nothing for me walking a Roman start a fire.
Violently, three quarter of the earth. When it reaches full, the whole earth will moan. Like the whole earth. The whole earth will moan in agony. Right? I'm just giving you all a little heads up. Right. So Yellowstone, or to give it Yellowstone. Now on the day of the solar eclipse, you will see other heavenly bodies. As you know it as planets. Right? You will see other planets or heavenly bodies. Yeah. Right?
Again.
Yes, I am. Highly. I never warm, forever burning. Can you see when the tables turn? Me say I love, I and I greeting. So every land of faith will burn. I was there when the ships came and chastised in a Jesus name. Wonder if me crazy, wonder if me sane. But the whole of Rome I go up in a flame. I know nothing to me walk in a Roman start a fire. And I know nothing to me walk in a Roman start a fire. God, them a one job, how a little African. I go burn down the whole in a Vatican. But I know nothing for me walking around. Start a fire. If you go home, the whole demography. And when me talk, I mean no hypocrite. When you say Rome, I eat no geography. But if I you feel wear the cap, then I you will have it. When you say Rome, you talk all I had. I you will see Lassie, I the power of the giant. The eagle and the dragon and the bear are spit fire. But they can't overthrow the conquering lion.
Listen to the voice of the people. Today Rome will burn. And me alone as the over evil. Say today Rome will burn.
No nothing for me walking a Roman start a fire. Yes, no nothing for me walking a Roman start a fire. Me say a fire because them a ask how a little African. I go ignite the whole in a Vatican, but I know nothing for me walking a Rome start a fire. Yes, I know me alone. I call a come, death gonna walk with the eye call a bun. And when you feel a earthquake, shake down a ground and a gun. As she has got a phone. I know nothing for me walking a Roman start a fire. And I know nothing for me walking a Roman start a fire.
I tell my heart, oh a little African. I go ignite the whole in a Vatican.
And I know nothing for me walking in a Roman start a fire.
I'm just listening to the voice of the people. Today Rome will burn. But I'm not alone as a over evil. Said today Rome will burn. Said listen to the voice of the people. Rome will burn. I know me alone. Today.
You know me.
Share something with you.
Oh God,
share something with you.
out and be our motives.
So the life struggling.
Leading God's children.
Struggling to get shares and struggling to get viewers. That is what the enemy did to my life from reaching out. But I'm happy that most people is getting to really accept and listen and hear the real truth.
To the promised land, music is the voice.
So Facebook put a lockdown on my life where I could only reach a little amount of people. So you can see that very clear face there, right? Of King Yahushua. So what about now? So make sure and share this live.
46 kilometers left, W. Dehusko, blast, minor, magnitude, 3.0, 22 minutes ago.
So I have a lot to show you today. And one of the things that I'm going to show you is the dome. I'm going to be showing you the dome today. Yes, the glass dome. You're going to be seeing a full live video of the dome today. Elohim has shown us real love, real patience for far too long now, right? So we want to give Elohim the love and everything from our hearts with this song.